Sewing for beginners. Learn to sew and make your own clothes. If you have absolutely no knowledge of sewing, this movie will get you started. Sewing for beginners. Making clothes is about joining pieces of cloth, understanding some simple rules of construction, and learning how to do it neatly. The type of fabric you choose will help you to be successful while you're learning. A lightweight tweed such as this is a great starting point. Avoid plain silks. Satin is particularly tricky. Plain sheers. Plain dressy fabrics in general are best left until you have more experience. Every wiggle and pucker will show up. Fine suiting fabric needs some skill, and when you have stripes and checks, matching is an added complication. Start with lightweight denim and chambray. Pure cottons always press up well. Patterned silks are easy to work with. Lace is fun and not at all difficult. Bold patterned fabrics that don't need matching. Simple construction using bold fabrics is easy to achieve for even the first time seamstress. Check out lightweight furnishing fabrics. There is a lot of scope here for bold prints for impact. I found these two lengths in the remnant bin this week. I'm hoping there is enough of this for a little cropped jacket to go with blue jeans. And this lovely stripe would also make a super jacket for the evening. Get to know your sewing machine. Before you do any sewing, make sure you are familiar with your sewing machine. All sewing machines are provided with a manual, and if you haven't got one, you should be able to get one online. All the information about threading and tension will be explained. Machines vary, and I am not an expert on all the models on the market today. This manual has a section on the different sewing machine needles available. I mostly use universal needles in various sizes, from 70/10 for lightweights, 80/12 for medium fabrics, and 90/14 for heavier fabrics. There are other needles you can try, depending on your fabric. Ballpoint needles for jersey, denim needles that are extra strong, and top stitching needles that have a larger eye for the heavier thread. For perfect sewing, renew your needle often. It's best to start each garment with a new needle. If you're lucky, your manual will give you plenty of guidance on the range of sewing feet available and how to use them. Do look up sewing machines on Wikipedia. The history is fascinating. Equipment. You don't need much equipment to get started. Fabric shears. I like to have two sizes and keep them just for fabric. Paper scissors for cutting out patterns. A tape measure. This one has inches and centimetres. A handy measuring guide is extremely useful. Google 14-in-1 measuring gauge for this one. I'm always being asked. For hand sewing, a thimble. I like to use a tailor's thimble, which is open at the end. It goes on the third or middle finger and is used to push the needle into the fabric as you make a stitch. Small sharp scissors for snipping threads. Tweezers are handy. A stitch ripper is not just for mistakes, but useful for buttonholes. Chalk for marking. A pack of sewing needles. Sharps are best for most hand sewing jobs. Pins and a pin cushion. Ballpoint pins are best for jersey knits. Keep them separate. Understanding a few basic techniques is next. Straight stitching. If this really is the first time you have used a sewing machine, spend a few minutes practicing sewing in a straight line. Cut up a few squares of spare fabric. For a basic seam, take two pieces and with right sides together, pin at right angles to the raw edge. We will stitch a seam with a seam allowance of 5/8 of an inch. Measure and chalk in the line if you like. We also need to learn how to stitch darts. Darts are used to shape our garment. Imagine this one is a bust dart. Fold the garment piece along the dart fold, carefully matching our notch marking at the edge. I like to pin at the point to mark the end of the dart. Then pin along the dart line. Add a few pins at right angles. First, we stitch the straight seam. Start a little way in and sew in reverse first to secure the stitching. Many machines have guidelines on the sole plate to help you. Guide the fabric without pulling or pushing. Let the feed dog draw the fabric through. Sew slowly over the pins. As long as you have a sharp needle, you won't have a problem. When you get to the end, sew a few stitches in reverse again. Now for the darts. Again, secure the ends with a few stitches in reverse. Take out the pins along the stitching line as you go, sewing over the pins that are at right angles. As you approach the dart point, shorten the stitch a little and continue sewing straight off the edge. Leave long threads to tie off.